LP10 electronic and LP50 electronic, changing the electronic module and batteries. Firstly, remove the grip by unscrewing the grip screw with a 2.5mm ball-ended driver. With the grip removed, the cable and the connector for the electronics are visible. Use two fingers to carefully separate the two parts of the connector. Then open the cover plate, using a 2mm Allen key to remove the screws. The plate can then be lifted off. With a screwdriver, carefully ease the electronic module out of the grip and remove this together with the attached cable. The new module is now inserted. You will see that the cable is spring-loaded, which allows it to be extended as far as possible. Feed the cable through the grip. Holding the cable with one hand, use your other hand to position the new module in the grip. Use a screwdriver on the battery holder to press the module in place. The spring-loaded cable and its connector should freely extend and return back into the grip. The electronic module is correctly installed. Now, how to correctly replace the batteries. Although we have, there is no need to dismount the grip to change the batteries. Hold the electronic module down and with a small screwdriver, lift the two AAA batteries out. Within the battery panel, there are markings to show the correct direction in which the batteries must be inserted. Through operating the on and off switch, you are able to see if the batteries are full or empty. When the lamp flashes quickly, there is sufficient power from the batteries. But when the lamp flashes slowly, this indicates that the batteries are low and must be replaced. The plate is replaced and secured with both screws. Once again, a short flashing of the control lamp means that there is full voltage from the batteries. Now we reattach the grip. Pull out the cable connector. With the correct installation of the module, the cable should be free to extend and then return into the body of the grip. Join the connector and combine the grip and the weapon together. Rattle the parts a little to make sure that the cable is free and it has returned back to its ideal position. Turn the weapon over in order to mount the grip. Take time to ensure that the grip screw is in the correct position. It may take a few attempts to find this position, but be patient. Tighten the screw whilst wobbling the grip a little, as this will ensure the perfect seating of the grip upon the weapon. Check the trigger and in doing so, switch the pistol on.